this is a tutorial questions that we solved in fluid mechanics course. So here the question is, a belt moves upwards at velocity v, dragging a film of viscous liquid of thickness h, as shown in the figure. Near the belt, the film moves upwards due to the no slip, and at its outer edge, the film moves downwards due to gravity. Assuming that the only non-zero velocity is v of x with zero shear stress at outer film edge, we have to derive a formula for v of x, and then the next question is we have to find the average velocity in the film and the velocity vc for which that there will be no net flow either up and down, and then we have to sketch the velocity profile that is given in case c. So we will see how it will be done. So, as it is said in the question that the belt is moving in positive y direction. So, let us assume that we have the velocity components in x, y, z direction as u, v and w. Because there is the flow is only in y direction, u and w will be 0. And then so because of that, now first we can use continuity equation. Which is rho del u equal to 0, and we can write it as dou z equal to 0. And since u and w are 0, so we are left with dou v by dou y is equal to 0. So it clearly shows that the velocity in y direction is only dependent on x direction because there will be no flow in z direction. Then moving on to conservation equation, momentum conservation equations. First we write in x direction. So, because u is 0 and it is steady state, so this will be 0, u is 0. So, whole equation will be going to 0 and we will be left with dou p by dou x is equal to 0, which shows that the pressure variance in x direction will be there will be no pressure variance in x direction. Then coming to y direction, so this we will assume that it is steady state, again u is 0, and from continuity equation we saw that dou v by dou y is 0, and then here the w is 0. And coming to this viscous term, again dou square v by dou y square is 0, dou, and sorry, there is no flow in z direction, so this will be 0. And from the x direction, we can say because there is no pressure change in x direction, if we because of that, at the outer edge of the film, the it is always atmospheric pressure. So along x there will be no pressure difference, and along y it will only be atmospheric pressure. So that's why dou p by dou y will be 0. So then we are only left with mu dou square v by dou x square plus rho g y equal to 0, and because the fluid is moving up, g y the gravitation force in y direction will be minus g. So this will become rho dou square v by dou x square equal to rho g, and we can write it in differential equation as dou square v by dou x square equal to rho g by mu. So we will be solving this equation. So we have d square by dy square, sorry, dx square equal to rho g by mu. So, we will be integrating with x. So, first it will become dou v by dou x equal to rho g mu x plus c1, and v rho g mu by x square by 2 plus c1x plus c2. So, now coming to the boundary conditions, we can say that at x equal to 0, because the belt is moving, there will be no slip. It is also given in the question. So therefore, at the at x equal to 0, velocity will be same as the velocity that the belt is moving with, and then at x equal to h, it is said that there is zero shear stress. So tau y x equal to 0, this means dv by dx will also be 0. So using these two boundary conditions, we will find out the two integration constants. First we will use boundary condition 1. We will substitute in the equation 2. So it will be v. So c2 will turn out to be the velocity with which the belt is moving, and when we apply the boundary condition 2, we have the equation here, dv by dx equal to rho g by mu into x plus c1. So it will become, so d so at boundary condition 2 is at x equal to h, dv by dx is 0, so c1 will be minus rho g h by mu. So therefore, the whole equation will become the velocity profile is v of x equal to rho g by mu x square by 2 minus rho g h by mu x plus v. So this will be the velocity profile. So that solves the A bit. Next, coming to the B bit, where they actually asked us to calculate the average velocity. So we can calculate average velocity by taking integration of v of x over thickness h. So it will be 1 by h going from 0 to h v of x. So from here we will get So if we solve this, So therefore, the average velocity in the total film will be rho g, v minus rho g h square by 3. So while by solving that, we'll get this equation. So this is the expression for v average. And then it is asked in CBIT that at what value of velocity the net flow will be 0. So when the average velocity in the film will be equal to 0, that is when we say that there will be no net flow. So for the CBIT, when V average is equal to 0, that means there is no net flow. So therefore, V will be rho g h square by 3. And the D bit is, we have to actually plot this profile where the net flow is 0. We have to plot a velocity profile for that. So that means V of x will be rho g by mu x square by 3 minus rho g h by mu x. And V, because we are taking the condition for the C bit, the V will be rho g h square by 3. So if we take rho g h square by mu as common, we'll end up with an quadratic equation. I think I missed. You here. So this is again the critical velocity at which there will be no net flow. So V of x by Vc will be x by h square minus x by h plus 1. So if we plot, let's say this is the origin, this is x by h, this is v of x by vc. So when x by h is 0, we know that at x equal to 0 the belt is moving, so this whole one will be 1. And when x by h is 1, so that is when that is the outer edge. And if we substitute that here, we will end up with a value minus 0.5. So that means the flow will start from a positive value. And it will decrease like this. So, and if we solve this quadratic equation, we will end up with the value x by h equal to 0.42. So this is the value where the flow becomes from positive to negative. So this will be the velocity profile, and this is 0.42. So that is what this question, the answer for this question is. So coming to the second question. So this question deals with packet beds. So as you can see in the question, it's given that water flows through 3.6 kg of glass particles of density 2590 kg per meter cube, which forms a packet bed of depth 0.475 meter and diameter of the column is 0.0757 meter. And so in table below they have given the range of the volumetric flow rate and the frictional pressure drop across the bed with the water flow. So in this question we have to demonstrate that the flow that is given here is a laminar flow, and then we have to estimate the diameter of the particles, then we have to find the relevant Reynolds number. So we'll solve the question. So these are the given values. So mass of the glass particles is 3.6 kg and the density of the glass particles is 2590 kg per meter cube. The depth of the bed or the length of the bed is 0.475 meters and the diameter of the column, the packet bed column, is 0.0757. So the values that are given for volumetric flow rates and pressure drop. And pressure drop values are 5.5, 0.0, 14.5, 29.5, 36.5. So first we will change the values for the Q from like to SI units. So well, volumetric flow rate in meter cube per second. So it will be 3.33, 6.67. 8.33, 11.67, 16.67, and 20. And delta P in Pascal units will be 733.27, 1599.87. And next we will calculate velocity, which is Q by A, and the area will be the cross sectional area of the packet bed with the diameter 0.0757. So these values turn out to be 7.4, 14.82, 18.51, 25.93, 7.04, 44.44. So if we plot a graph between the delta P and V, if these points form, like if we draw a straight line through these points, if they form a linear profile, then we can say that the flow is laminar. And with these values, actually this, if we plot delta P versus V, we will get a linear plot. So that means it says the flow is laminar. Or we can also calculate the slopes otherwise. And so these slopes will be one point one six, 0.9, 1.07, 1.08, 1.26. So you can see that there is the consistent value of around 1, And if we take an average of these values, we will get a value around 1.1. So this is the average slope that we get from the plot. And so the next question was, we have to find the diameter of the particles that we that they have used, the glass particles. So for that, first we write Ergun's equation, and for in laminar flow, the Ergun's equation will reduce to delta P by L 150 mu V 1 minus epsilon square by dP square by dP square into epsilon omega or epsilon cube. So we have to find dP square. For that we need to find the epsilon also. We have been given the mass of the particle bed, so we will use that. So mass of the particle bed the given is 3.6 kg, and the mass will be totally equal to the volume into the density and the porosity. So the volume will be equal to the cross sectional area into the length of the bed into rho and 1 minus epsilon, and this is 3.6. So the area will be d square into length is 0.475, and density of the glass particles is 2590. 1 minus epsilon equal to 3.6, so which will give epsilon as 0.3498. And since the flow is laminar, as I said before, we can get the slope. And the slope, when we draw, when we construct delta P versus V, the slope is actually equal to, from the equation, the slope will be equal to 150 mu 1 minus epsilon square dP square epsilon cube. So this will be the slope, and this was equal to 1.1 into 10 power 6. So if we put the values for epsilon in this expression, the particle diameter will be turn out to be 8 into 10 power minus 4 meter, or 800 micrometers. So now we got the diameter of the particle also. Next we have to find the relevant Reynolds number, and Reynolds number will be equal to dV rho by omega, sorry, mu into 1 minus epsilon, and we have 800 to 10 power minus 6, and we can take any velocity. Here we can take the maximum velocity to see whether even at the maximum velocity whether the flow is laminar or not. So we will take 44.44 into 10 power minus 4, density of the fluid 0.01 into 1 minus epsilon will be 1 minus 0.3498. So this will give us a value around 5.5, which is again which will show that it is a laminar flow. So that's how we solve this problem.